preach and what not to preach. We don't need no government funding. If we pay our tithes and offering and sow where we're being fed, this church can prosper. Let me say it again. Quit sending your money to the TV preachers who ain't coming to see you when you're in the hospital. They come to town, they get Rupp Arena, and everybody run down the Rupp Arena, and you sow the seed. Can't get you to sow seed here to get toilet paper. And somebody come in from out of town, they don't know you, ain't met you, ain't never buried none of your family members, they never visited you in the hospital, and say one thing, and you sow the seed of $5, can't get you to give $50 in your local church. Do I feel a cool breeze behind me?
You're faking, God. You're faking.
Thank you. You plant your seed where you're being fed. Let me say it again. You plant your seed. If you believe this is good ground, then you ought to plant your seed here. A pocket full of seed in your pocket and that goes in the ground don't mean nothing. Bishop, oh, I guess I ain't gonna preach, but I came to preach. I see that now. It's better to be a blessing than it is to be blessed. That's what I'm talking about, the seed. If I walk here with a pocket full of $100 bills, that don't mean nothing. As long as it stays in my pocket, it ain't gonna grow. Oh, the bishop, all that money the bishop got, he ain't doing nothing with it. But when you take that seed and plant it in fertile ground, there's no way you can sow in the kingdom of God and there's not a return. And I'm not a prosperity preacher, but I will preach what the Bible says. And it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, run over, shall men give it to your bosom. Bring ye all the tithes unto the strong, and there may be meat in my house. And listen to what God said. God, this ain't your boss, this ain't the president. God said, prove me. There's some of you looking and say, you know, Bishop, I will preach, but I want a fixed income. That makes two of us. I'm on one too. Every time I pay my tithes, God fixes it. Ain't nobody listening to me. Y'all ain't getting happy. I say, every time I pay my tithes, God fixes my income. Can I get a witness? He said, if you do it, I'll open up the windows of heaven, pour you on a blessing, that there will not be room enough. When you know better to do what you're God, you're telling God I'm smarter than you. I know better to do with my money than what you prescribe in your word. I guarantee you, if you tithe and be consistent in your tithe payment, blessings will come upon you such as you've never seen. Yes, and it won't always be financial. Amen. Y'all know I'm a Toyota man, don't y'all?
Come on.
You know the car I talked about last year?
Yeah.
And the year before that?
Yeah.
My 2005 Toyota Avalon?
Right.
That coming here, I turned over 343,000 miles. Somebody say Toyota. I'm only speaking in tongues when you say that, amen. I saw quite a few of them when I came in today. Praise God, amen. You're in the kingdom, amen. Praise God. ran 43,000 plus miles and is still riding like a brand new car. The Lord says, when you pay your tithes, I'll rebuke the devourer for your sake. When you pay your tithes, he lets stuff that's in your house that should have broke down a long time ago keep on running. I guess I'm not going to preach it. Because maybe the Lord want to do some other talking to you all today. Can I get a witness in the building? Huh? Maybe that's the miracle that some of y'all need. Maybe I need a miracle by being obedient and going back to being obedient to God's word. And if I become obedient to God's word, then the thing he promised me he could do that he hadn't been able to do because I wasn't obedient, now he's going to do it because I said yes to your will. And you've been blaming the devil. Satan be crying something, they blame everything on me. Because everything ain't the devil. Some stuff you're going through because you have not obeyed God. And what no sense of Jonah blaming the devil for the storm that came on the ship. He knew what the problem was when everybody else was calling on their gods and throwing stuff overboard. Jonah down there knocked out. The man that brought the trouble was asleep. And when he woke him up, Jonah said, I know what the problem is. It's me. Ooh, there's nothing like admitting to yourself I'm the problem. I'm the reason. Where the Lord is speaking in here today. I'm the reason. There may be some people here who need to fess up, not to each other, but to God. David said, it's me, oh Lord, I'm the one that sinned. Against you and heaven. I ain't gonna blame Bathsheba because she was naked. No, it's me. I didn't have to go and do what I did. Yes. See, sometimes we need to learn to man up. Yes. Sometimes we need to man up and call it what it is. Yes. I'm the problem. I'm the one that caused it. I was the one that was texting when I drove. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We need to admit it. It's me, oh Lord. That's why trouble's in my life. It's me. And how do you know it was really Jonah? Because when he threw him over, the storm ceased. And maybe when we get to confess and throwing some stuff out in our lives, maybe some of the storms we're going through will come to an end. I hear you, Holy Ghost. He said, that's some of the miracles I'm talking about.
Yes.
I need to go back and do my first works over again.
Yes.
I need to go back and fall on my knees and go back to talking to God and quit watching so much television.
Yes.
Because these are evil times we're living in.
Yes.
To all my young folk, I don't know what it's going to be like when y'all get my age. I really don't. 30, 40 years from now, I don't know what's going to be like for you all. I really hate even thinking about it. What's going to be? It's rough down here now. Things are bad and corrupt now. The days is evil now. What is it going to be like 40 years from now?